they talk about sex with men in Aisha.
We agree he has sex with his wife, Aisha.
Right. And Aisha was a nine-year-old child who Muhammad has sex with. We're in agreement. Because we're looking at issues that we have as Christians in regards to Muhammad's prophet. And so we're looking at his morality. Yeah? So can we agree on that? That Aisha did Muhammad did have sex with
him? We can agree he has sex with his wife.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Let's see.
He married Aisha. He has sex with her, so there's no problem.
Right, you know the best thing to do? I always say the best thing to do is let's look at what the hadith said. Yeah? Because Sahih Bukhari would probably be the better person to answer this. Alright, so let me get into it says in Sahih Bukhari 762-64, it says narrated Aisha that the Prophet married her when she was 6 years old, and he consummated his marriage when she was 9 years old, and then she remained with him for 9 years. Okay, so he married when she was 6 years old, and they consummated, they had sex when she was 9 years old. Again, Sahih Bukhari 7265, narrated Aisha, the Prophet married her when she was 6 years old, and he consummated his marriage when she was 9 years old. Hisham said, I have been informed that Aisha remained with the Prophet for 9 years. Even other hadiths, let me find other hadiths that state the same thing.
Get to the point, man, you've established it.
No, I take my time. Let's look at, so we've established it. Okay, yeah, fair enough, we've established it. Yeah, we both agree that Muhammad, a 53-year-old man, roughly that, 53, 54, man had sex with a 9-year-old child.
We both agree.
Aisha.
We both agree.
So we both agree.
He married Aisha and he has sex with his wife. You are talking about hadith.
He married her at what age?
No, you are talking about hadith here. Wait. You're talking about hadith here. You're talking about hadith.
Yes, I am talking about hadith.
Example. The Shia. No, wait. The Shia example don't agree with this hadith, by the way. They are in Sahih Muslim, Sahih Bukhari, Muslim, Sunni hadith book. But here, Muslims don't see any problem. If this hadith is fabricated hadith, we don't have problem. If it's correct hadith, we don't have problem. We take it.
Okay,
do you understand?
So you're not having a problem with the hadith?
No, Sahih. I'm saying authentic, I'm putting a condition. Actually, myself, I didn't look at if the hadith is correct or not. I know the hadith is there. Myself,
you know it's there, right? Okay.
Yeah,
so we're in agreement. We're in agreement.
No, we agree the hadith is there. But the question is it the hadith correct or not?
All due respect, Omar, I think you're waffling a little bit, and I think because you don't answer this question. I want to get to the agreement, yeah? Before I move on to my question I have for you. Do we agree that Muhammad had sex with 9-year-old child Aisha?
We can agree he had sex with his wife.
With his wife, who was a 9-year-old child called Aisha?
That's a debate.
So you don't, that's what I'm trying to, it takes you so long to get an answer from me.
It's based on hadith. Based on hadith.
But do you agree with Sahih Bukhari and Sunan Abu Dawud?
That's why I said myself, I did not look at the hadith if it's Sahih or not.
Have you ever read? Because I'm looking at your eyes.
No. Listen.
Have you ever read?
It's not because you are reading the hadith. What I'm saying is the hadith will be classified as hadith, correct hadith, or weak hadith. You know that. But myself, I didn't look at the end of the hadith if it's correct or not.
Do you agree that Sahih is a strong hadith?
I agree that I don't agree every hadith in Sahih hadith is correct hadith.
Do you agree that Sahih Bukhari is a strong hadith? That's the question I asked.
I agree most of the hadith in Sahih Bukhari are correct hadith.
Right. So my question to you again, right? I showed you a couple of sources. I can show you. I can show you many sources.
Yes. What is your point?
But I first want to affirm something. Did he have sex with a 9-year-old child? His wife was Aisha. Did he have sex with her? Now, yes, he did. Okay, right. So we agree that. We now agree that Muhammad had sex with his wife, which is a 9-year-old child, Aisha. He married her when she was 6, and they had sex. Okay. So my question is this then, did she give consent to marry Muhammad? Because obviously marriage, we can assume marriage involves sex, but did she give her consent to marry?
So.
No, I'm not asking you what you believe. I'm not asking you your,
how
your
can,
opinion.
How can I answer this question? Was I there?
Right.
I wasn't there.
Right. So,
you
do you have any sources to show that a 9-year-old child gave a 54-year-old man who possibly had a big grey beard and wanted to have sex with her? She desired to have sex with or to marry this big old man.
The father of Aisha is a close friend of my prophet. Do you understand?
What?
The parent, if they're not happy, even before the prophet started preaching, the father of Aisha was the closest friend of the prophet. That's why when the prophet started preaching, his father wasn't there. He was traveling in business. When he came back, he did not doubt any single word what the prophet said about the angel Gabriel spoke to him. He tried to believe. He's one of the first people to believe in him. Because he has this experience, friendship.
Abubakar.
Yeah, before Islam. So Islam, the prophet, Abu Bakr, the father of Aisha, never complained. You don't see anywhere where he complained about the marriage. You don't see anywhere where Aisha complained about the marriage. So there's no problem. I don't see what point you are talking about. You are talking about his wife. You can't deny that. He married her.
Okay, let me respond to you.
Yeah. What is your point about
Let me respond to you.
I want to see your point.
That was a great answer to the wrong question. I want to answer to my question. My question is, does this 6-year-old child have the cognitive faculties or the ability, or you know, was she in a mature state to draw a conclusion that she wants to have sex or marry this 54-year-old quote-unquote, or this so-called prophet of Islam? And that's what I'm asking you. Did she give her consent? And I'm saying, do you have any sources? If you don't have any sources, that's fine. I'm asking you, is there any sources that show that she gave consent?
I don't.
Okay, can I read you?
I'm not saying it's not there.
That's fine. Can I read you this quote? If you can just elaborate on this quote. Okay. So, let me just get to you. Alright, so Sahih Bukhari. Right, so narrated, Aisha, the prophet engaged me when I was a girl, 6 years old. We went to Medina and stayed at home, at the home of Bani al-Harith bin Kazaj. When I got ill and my hair fell out, fell down. Later on, my hair grew again. And my mother, Ruman, came to me while I was playing in a swing with some of my girlfriends. She called me and I went to her, not knowing what she wanted to do to me. Unexpectedly, Allah's apostle came to me in the forenoon and my mother handed me over to him. And at that time, I was a girl of 9 years of age. Sahih Bukhari, 558, 234. So,
did you say 6 and 9?
No, Sahih Bukhari, volume 5.
No. Aisha, talking
no,
about.
No, it was 9. So, I was a girl of 9 years of age.
At the beginning, you said 6.
No, I didn't. I said 9. And so, here she says, not knowing what? She said, look, I'll read it to you again. I was playing in the swing. She's a little girl playing in the swing, playing with her dolls. She called me, her mother, Ruman, she called me and I went to her, not knowing what she wanted to do to me. Unexpectedly, Allah's apostle came to me in the forenoon and my mother handed me over to him. And at that time, I was a girl of 9 years of age. In this text, it's explicit that she did not know. It says, use words like not knowing, unexpectedly. She did not know Muhammad was coming. She did not know what her mother wanted from her. And she did not know that her mother was going to hand her to Muhammad in marriage. So the question I'm asking you is, do you have any sources that would conflict with this, that shows that Aisha, at the age of 9, or even at the age of 6, when she got married, at the age of 6, that she knew, or she gave her consent to be married?
According to the hadith you are reading, she's saying she was 9.
No, I'm saying we know that she married at the age of 6, because we just read the hadiths, and at 9, they consummated the marriage. So what that goes to show me is even at this age of 6, she didn't even realize but what she was getting into as a 6-year-old child. Hold on, let me finish.
And now, please, that's your standard.
I promise I'll respond to you. Yeah, I'm just looking at what the hadith say. At 6 years old, she didn't even realize that she was engaging in marriage, because at the age of 9, he says in the hadith, unexpectedly, unknowingly, my mother just handed me over to Muhammad. So how could she know she was entering into this institution, this wedding matrimony, or she was in a marriage, if at 9 she did not even know? She was it was unexpected to her. Why am I going with this big old prophet, 54 years old, and my mom giving it to him? This is what your hadith says. So my question to you is, do you have anything in your sources contrary to this text?
That's what I'm asking. I don't think so. I don't deny if there is a hadith or not.
Okay.
Because hadiths are thousands. Okay. You yourself are just picking up, choosing the hadiths that you want to talk about. You know, Sahih Bukhari is thousands of hadith. Many books are found in the same book.
You know what I'm going to do? Go back and research that.
I don't have a problem.
My question to you,
where's your problem with this? We are talking about mom and dad willingly taking their daughters to give the friend of the father.
Let me tell you my problem. Let me tell you my problem with that. Evidence, scientific studies show that a child is not able to give consent, or is not at the mature age to give consent. Let me just give you just... Can I respond and then you respond to me? Anybody who gets married, when I got married, I'm a married man. Many Muslims here are married people. One of the things that I hope people ask, yes, it's fine to have arranged marriages and things like that. One of the things we want to know is that, especially when my daughter is going to marry someone, my daughter which grows up, she'll marry someone, or I go into marriage myself, I want to give my consent to marry. So it's a simple question from a Christian. Why is it that Muhammad, where we have no sources that show that Aisha gave consent to be involved in a lifetime commitment, in a contractual agreement for the rest of her life, to be married to someone, to sleep with someone, to perhaps cook for them, and all these things, these obligations they have? Where is it that she gave consent to be involved? How does she have the mindset at 6 years old to know that? Now, let me quickly read you this, yeah? It says this. It's a BMC Public Health. Many modern information in regards to, you can look it up anywhere you want, in regards to what scientists and studies say about young children. Okay, early sexual invitations, exposes adolescents to increased risk of STI, HIV, infection, unintended pregnancies, unsafe abortion. In addition, the health of a young girl is compromised during childbirth, as they are more prone to maternal morbidity and mortality due to their psychological immaturity. Infant and child deaths are also likely to occur to adolescents, mothers. So speaking about very young children, and the problems when a big grown man is having sex with a very tiny child, you have problems during childbirth, you have problems psychologically, and you have all kind of issues in regards to this. That's why it's so important. The law states that a child needs to know what she's doing. She has to give consent. A woman who wants to get married must first give consent, because they have to understand what they're psychologically and physically giving themselves away to. Okay? Let me just read you one more.
That's your own law. We as a Muslim, the fathers, the parents, the guardians. It does matter as a Muslim, talking about as Islam, as Muslims. The Quran calls the parent to save the child from hellfire. Do you understand? So if the parent are willingly, we don't have a problem.
I'm sorry, can you repeat that?
If the parent are willing, okay, we don't have a problem with that.
Okay, I'm going to kind of round this off.
Yeah.
So, are you saying you would also, if a parent is willing, you, Omar, how would you?
No, it's not about me here.
Would you have sex with a 9-year-old child?
No, I'm talking about willing to offer a marriage.
No, your standard.
What you are talking about here, like he's not his wife.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Okay.
He's his wife. He married her.
Okay, listen.
He has a right to sleep with her.
Okay, let's go further on the question. So, if a child was a 6-year-old girl and her parents handed her over to you in marriage, would you, Omar, have sex with this child?
You are not talking about me. You're talking about
you're saying that the Prophet is
your... The Prophet can do things which I cannot do.
Where does it say that?
No, I'm saying the Prophet can do something which I cannot do. The Prophet has done things which Muslims are not allowed to do. Only the Prophet does.
Is the Prophet your perfect role model?
Second.
Is the, according to the Quran, is the perfect, the best role model for mankind?
You see him,
he's the best role model. So right now we're looking at morality. We're looking at, is he really, as the Muslims claim, the perfect role model?
Yes.
Morally role model. Yeah. When the Muslims themselves have a better ethic than he does, because they would not choose to have sex with a 9-year-old child.
Actually, some countries marry girls young age. If you go to the Sahara, girls grow up quickly.
That's not a question. No,
you are talking about Muslims now. I'm telling you what is happening. And then you have to understand this is 1,439, more than that, history we are talking about.
So you agree with me that because the Prophet is the so-called Prophet of Islam, is the perfect role model for mankind, you are in agreement with Muslims and other nations, whatever, who have sex with a 9-year-old child. You are in agreement with
them. I'm talking about his wife. He married this woman.
Yes, with their wives who are children. You are in agreement with those Muslims that have sex with them.
Where is your problem? Where is your problem with that?
Someone marry.
No. Wait. Someone marry a woman. They have right to have sex with the woman.
Where
is your point
problem
here?
Let me give you some more problems.
I don't see any problem here. Okay. If he didn't marry the woman, then I can support
you. Let me give you some more problems. Let me read a couple of things. So,
we're looking at
the forensic psychiatry, Leslie Stevens, the MBBS. We're looking at what the definition of rape is. Yeah? Definition of rape is, rape is defined as penetration by the penis or the vagina, anus or mouth of another person without consent.
But do you see why it's so important that we need to know?
That's
not what we believe. Believe he married this woman.
Right.
As the hadith you came to read, what happened, what Aisha was talking about, she's reporting what happened to her.
Did Aisha give consent? You haven't given evidence.
I'm telling you, the Quran gave consent to the Prophet to marry her.
And you know, Abu Bakr,
huh? Even this law,
I've given you the definition of rape. You can look it up, you can Google it. The definition of rape is someone...
I don't see it rape. You can see it anything. You can name it anything. But I see it a man marrying a woman. They can sleep together. There's no problem there.
You just admitted that although you yourself would not have sex with a 9-year-old child, but you understand why other men in other nations... You just said it in your... It's on camera. You said that you understand why other men in other nations...
No, I'm telling you why it's happening somewhere.
Right, and you agree with that, or do you disagree? Do you see the problem?
Don't pull me to that. I want to really stick to what you are talking about. Because you are bringing... You are throwing things...
But you see the problem you have?
The man...
This is the dilemma you have. Your conscience, your mind, everything about Omar, who's a decent human being, is saying, no, we should not do this. It's wicked, it's evil, and it's not godly.
You don't. No one complained. No one complained that time. No one. You don't see anyone, any family of the of Aisha, her parents, her family, extended family, any Muslim, any Arab that time complained about it. You don't see anything.
So
it's now, it's a few years later, this has been written in the 200 years before, after the Prophet. It's now people are talking about this.
So because you feel nobody's complained about it, that makes it right.
I'm not saying this.
Okay.
I'm saying this is in our books. It's there. You are taking. You are reading our books now. You didn't get it.
Okay, Omar, we've delivered. Let me just kind of run. So we've shown. I mean, and I can read numerous sources, numerous studies that show that sex with a minor or young girl causes physical damage, psychological damage. It's called abuse. Without consent, it's called rape.
It never affected Aisha.
So that's
one of the six person who wrote a lot of hadith. Okay. When you read Sahih al-Bukhari, the whole thing, many hadith is being reported by Aisha.
Okay. So my question to you is this. Why did Muhammad marry Aisha? That's my question to you. Because he obviously chose, he didn't, all of his other wives were not 6 years old.
And maybe there's a big reason.
Why did he marry?
Because she brought a lot of hadith. Maybe there's a big reason why she said.
But you have to understand.
The parents are willing to offer this girl to. It's like you taking your daughter off, offering your
best. Me giving her, no.
No, no, I'm saying it's like you taking a daughter, one of your daughter, and offering your friend. There's no problem.
So you think.
No, I'm
that my mind will come to the depth.
I'm talking
of offering
about
my 6 year old
child. I'm not talking about age. I'm talking about you taking your daughter.
Okay, let's deal with what you're saying. Imagine my daughter is 21. I would not give my daughter to somebody she did not give consent to. That is unethical, that's immoral, and I would not want her
that's
to
be. Oh,
You asked me. Omar, respectfully.
If you leave that time.
Omar, respectfully, you personalized it. You said me. You didn't say Muhammad, you didn't say yourself, you said me. So I'm giving you my answer. No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't give my daughter to someone she did not give consent to. But my question is this to you. You have an answer. Why is it that Muhammad married this girl? Especially the fact that other of his wives were older. So why did he marry Aisha? How do you explain this? If you don't know, I'll read you what your hadith
said.
Okay, so it says this. Narrated Jaabir ibn Abd-Allaah. When I got married, Allah the Prophet said to me, "What type of lady have you married?" I replied, "I have married a matron." He said, "Allah the Prophet said, why have you not married a virgin to fondle with each other?" Sahih Bukhari 338 504. Again, narrated Aisha. Umal Mumin says the Prophet used to kiss and suck her tongue when he was fasting. Sunan Abu Dawud 2380. Let me read you, this is very important. This is very careful. Jaabir also said, Allah's Apostle said, why don't you have a liking for virgins and for fondling them? Why didn't you marry a young girl so that you might play with her and she with you? It's clear and explicit. I can read you more. It says it in another in Sahih Bukhari and so on and so forth. It's clear that he's giving advice to another Muslim and saying, marry a young person, a virgin, so you can fondle them. We know that Muhammad kissed and, you know, stuck his tongue inside Aisha's mouth when he was fasting, when he was supposed to be fasting. We know that he fondled her, because that's what he's saying, that, you know, you should marry someone who's young and a virgin. And so, Omar, you really have to look at the reason behind this. Because as I'm looking at you, your conscience is in a conflict with this text. You say, no, I don't agree with this. But it's because it's Muhammad, I have to agree with you. You don't have to. You can say, no, this is wrong, and I won't follow Muhammad.
This is a hadith. That's what I'm telling you. And the correct hadith. There's many. You are reading just hadith from, say, Bukhari. You know, Muslims don't say every hadith is, say, Bukhari is correct hadith. You know that. You know it. So for me here, there's no problem. He married this. If the woman, if he didn't marry with this, he just took her, then there's a big problem. Because Prophet don't do that. But he married her. You have to understand. This woman, this Aisha, was the wife of the Prophet.
Okay.
I don't see any problem with that.
Should I tell you?
And then while I was saying example to you, you are saying this few years back, you can take your daughter, give it to someone without the consent of the girl. If you live a few years back in the country where I come from, this happened. Where I'm from, Ivory Coast. This happened.
Ivory Coast.
Yeah, they normally give, they normally choose the girl for the, choose husband for the girl. I got a friend. She's Pakistani. No, she's in India, Muslim. Her parent wanted to go a man from Qatar to marry her. Huh? Apparent, all apparent.
I mean, so, the question, Omar.
So there's no problem in that. A few years back, people with, still today, some Muslims do that, even non-Muslims do. If they see you as a young man, because they think they will see something in you, they want their daughter to be your wife. And you understand?
Listen what I'm trying. I want to kind of. I don't want to have an agenda. I want to show you what I'm trying to do. I'm attempting to do. I'm trying to appeal to your morality because I know you're a moral person. I've seen you around, and you're genuinely. And most Muslims here, I'll be honest, most Muslims here are genuinely nice people when I meet them outside of the parks. They generally, you know, and when you come to Speaker's Corner, they just change into these super Dawah Muslims. And what I'm saying is that I'm appealing to your morality, yeah? Right? I know in your mind, you know that it's wrong, okay? I know in your mind that you know that it's immoral to have sex with a 9-year-old child. I know in your mind it's immoral to have sex with someone who didn't have consent, who didn't give consent. I know in your mind you think you know it's immoral to look at babies and say, I would, when they grow up, I'll have sex with them, like Muhammad did. And so when you look at the mind of Muhammad, almost on every single account, you disagree with him. But because you are bound to this, it doesn't matter what it says, Muhammad said it, I have to follow it regardless of how it strikes me. Because you know, God created you innately to have a conscience, to know right from wrong. And in your mind, it's frightening this, but you're looking at the ground and I can't fight.
So, my mind is not fighting.
And so what I'll say to you is this, is if this is the case, again, like I was saying, for example, here, Ibn Ishaq, the life of Muhammad, Prophet 311, page 311, says when she was a baby, crawling before him, and said, this is Prophet Muhammad, yeah, says if she grows up and I'm still alive, I will marry her. So he's looking at a baby.
What's the source?
Right, so when she's a baby,
I will marry her.
Yes.
Not that I will just grab her.
Yes.
He could have done that. He's in the power.
Okay.
You understand?
Okay.
He could have taken any woman without marrying her.
So that's point I'm addressing. I'm addressing to you. I know Omar will not look at a baby crawling and say, you know what, when she's older, I will marry her.
Do you not know that maybe there's a prophet. Maybe he sees something in this girl that can help bring Islam. Yes, because what I was telling you earlier, there's many hadiths is being reported by Aisha. Many hadiths. That's the woman, the wife, the only one in the wives of the prophet who reported more hadiths. There are hadiths that talk about people used to sit in front of them about the prophet.
What's wrong with promising your daughter to you?
So, just a minute, I'll just tell you. So my thing with this is
I don't see.
I'm painting a picture of a man who looks at a baby. I've never ever seen someone like yourself who look at a baby and actually contemplate marriage because the baby hasn't even developed yet.
Yeah, but he's a prophet.
Hold on.
He can see something in his
mind. Okay, that's fine. That's fine.
Yeah, you can see this.
You don't know about.
That's fine. So your case for this is that because he cannot, he might see something within the child that means, hold on one second, he'll see something within the child, which means that he would perhaps see her in the future if someone's better. Okay, let me address that. Why is it in your Quran, in Surah 64, I think Ayah 5, I'll find it in a second. Why does it state that, okay, so read it.
I'll tell you something.
Yeah.
Whatever the prophet done, something which God is not happy. The prophet, the Quran is straight with direct advice to the prophet. You understand? That tells you God was happy with this marriage. There's no problem. Otherwise, God is not shy to talk to the prophet. You know, there's many verses which has been addressed.
It's been in the verses. What verses?
I'm gonna find it.
What did you say?
What's the problem with? What's the problem? What's this issue with promising your daughters? There's a lot of cultures all over the Middle East, all over the Near East.
It's
a normal custom, it's not sexual at all. You can promise your
daughter.
That's
why I tell
you,
everyone agrees in that.
Okay.
Everyone does that.
I'm going to read you one second. Let me just read. So what I'm saying is this, is I see your defense. Your defense is that she looked at a baby and said, potentially, potentially, when she's older, because he's a prophet, he can have foresight to know that potentially he can marry her. So my question then to you was, what age can we go down to? Because we know that Muhammad had sex with a 9-year-old. How old, what's the youngest age of somebody who can have, according to Sharia law or Sharia, where you can have sex with a woman? What's the youngest age that we do?
There's no age.
There's no age. Right, now, see why there is a problem?
No, we don't. No.
Because can I just
say? There's a condition to have a marriage.
Ask him why.
It's not the condition. It's not age like in the law here. You have to be 16.
Yes.
You have to be 18 in some countries.
It wasn't even that. It's not.
Just one second. I'll address you next.
Because the condition here, you have to have the age. That's it. Okay. In Islam, there are many conditions.
Okay. So can I then? Would I then be correct in assuming?
Because if,
hold on, can I just respond to that? Would I then be correct in assuming that if there is no age limit, any age, age is respectable. So in other words, somebody can have married a 1-year-old, a 2-year-old, a 3-year-old, 4, 5, 6. Because you said there's no age.
The condition is not based on the age of the girl. It's not based on that. There's some condition. If you can assume anything, you can assume that. But you can also assume that then the Prophet married Aisha long 20 and then said 25.
I'm going
to that's what I'm saying.
I'm going by the statements you're making. Because let me read the Quran. So the Quran says this, it's Surah 65, verse 4. Okay, it says this, and as for those of your women who have despaired of menstruation, in case you have any suspicion, then their fixed spell shall be 3 months, along with those who have not menstruated. So these are girls who have not had a puberty yet. As yet. It says it there. Can you read it?
It said not menstruated.
Menstruated.
No, the word yet.
Do you want to go to the
Hadith? The word
yet.
That's fine. Hold on. Sir, can you stop heckling? You're part of the Islamic Dawah Team. I recognize you. And you are heckling. And the question I'm posing to Muhammad, to Omar, you can respond after. Okay, so let me respond. So let me continue reading. It says here that with those who have not menstruated, okay?
What is that?
Right? In this particular one, it says as yet, but I'll say menstruated.
No, because
that's fine.
Between the colour,
it's in brackets, yes. Okay. But it says, and those with burdens, i.e. those who are pregnant, their term is when they bring forth their burden, which is obviously a child, when they give birth, and whoever is pious to Allah, he will make for them of his. So the context... So you can read from, when you read the verse, the ayah before that, you see it's about marriage. Okay, it's speaking about marriage. And it's speaking about the age.
No, this is talking about period of woman.
Right.
That's the subject here.
Let's read it.
No, you have already read it.
Right, so if you look at the verse, just for people who are listening to this. It's about marriage. Just read the context before that. It's speaking about marriage. Almost look checking it right now. It's about marriage. About marrying. Okay? And it's speaking about when you can have sex with that person. You cannot have sex with someone who's it says here, let me just read it because I don't want to misquote it. And for those of women who have despaired of menstruation, in case you have any suspicion, then their spell shall be 3 months. If you have a suspicion that someone is currently on their period, don't have sex with them. Wait 3 months. And also, as for with those who have not even menstruated, so those who have not reached the age of puberty.
Where does it say that?
It says it here.
Where does it say not
menstruated?
Who have not menstruated, that's what it says.
Right.
Yeah,
he said, say who have.
Yeah, he said.
So,
yeah.
What is menstruated?
So, do you want to go to the tafsir?
Now you go to the explanation.
What is menstruated?
What you're doing?
No, show an explanation.
Because you see, that he said as yet. Huh? It's kind of.
You said as yet.
It's not in the original text. That's why it is.
Okay. You said menstruated. But here, what is menstruated mean?
Yes. Let's go to the tafsir. Ask the tafsir.
Baba, stop heckling him.
No,
allow him
to
read it and let him come with an answer, because you're kind of confusing him right now. Yeah, read into that. Read the context. Read what it's about. It's about marriage and when you can marry someone. But you know what's interesting? Why are you looking at that? What's interesting is Muhammad, according to the hadiths, it says that Muhammad was fondling Aisha while she was in menstruation. So he actually broke the law of Muhammad. Broke the law of Allah.
Did he penetrate?
According to the hadith.
How did he break the law? Did he penetrate?
According to the Quran.
Did he penetrate?
The Quran explicitly states, do not go near the woman. Muhammad.
So if you are saying they have not seen their period,
yes.
And then the context is talking about those people,
how can you
who you are not
by?
Sure when their periods end. Do you understand?
It doesn't say that.
No, the first.
Say that. You're reading something else.
No. The first one, ask, and those women from among you who have disappeared as well, menstruation.
You have not had
if
menstruation.
If you are in doubt, that means you are not sure.
Yeah, you're not sure if they're on their period.
Their idda is 3 months.
Right. So what does that mean
now,
to you? What does that mean to you?
No.
Explain that.
That idda, their period.
Yes. So what does that? What is he saying there? What is Allah saying to you right there?
He's telling you,
yes?
Example, if you are not sure when the
if
end,
they're on their period.
Yeah, you are not sure.
It says wait when, how long?
Is it 3 months?
Wait 3 months.
Yeah.
Then what does it say after that?
That's what I'm saying.
Yes.
That's the first part. As well as
yes?
Of those who have not yet seen their period. So you see, those as well is 3 months. No. Those as well. It says as well as of those. So those the ruling of those as well. They are the have same ruling for the first ruling for the first woman, 3 months.
So can I read what you're reading? Because I think you're reading.
It's the same text as well as of those who have not yet.
Yet menstruated.
Yeah.
Who have
wait
yet
now.
Menstruated.
Wait now. As for those having yeah. So those two they have same rulings. Do you understand? Both are 3 months in both cases. Do you understand?
You're not reading what
No. You are not understanding.
Okay. Yes? Maybe I'm not.
The first, you see, before you start reading, as for those having pregnancies, before you come there, there's two women God are talking about. Talking about two women. Both women have same rule, 3 months. So the second woman you are talking about, you are saying they have never seen their period. Does it don't make sense? If someone has never seen their period, you say their period is 3 months. Because we are talking about someone who they are already struggling to identify when to enter.
So my point again stands, Omar. My point is, and you've admitted this already, there is no age. There is no age explicitly stated. Can I respond?
I have to.
I have to
explain why I said it. It's better you ask me than.
Sir. I mean, Omar, respectfully, I allowed you to speak. Let me just respond to what you said. You've agreed with me. We are not in disagreement with this. There is no age in Islam, according to Sharia, that a person can marry. So hold on. Let me finish, and then you will respond. There is no age given. For example, in this country, you stated, it would be probably 16. Perhaps in another country, it'd be 18, and so on and so forth. So therefore, it opens the floodgates, if you like. Because Muhammad himself had sex with had married a six-year-old child. So the standard at the moment is 6 years old. But then you cannot show me, you haven't yet shown me, but no, hold on, no. actually you're wrong. It's older than 6 years, or it is six, or it's this particular age, or it's five, or four, or three. Any age goes. That's my point. So what I would conclude, because I have got to go back to church. What I'd conclude is this, yeah? My brother. What I'd conclude is this, is that please take time to really examine your conscience. Because the Omar conscience is saying, this is something I would not practice.
Again.
This is something I would not advise someone to do. This is something that is totally immoral. But the Quran and your prophet is doing something that goes against the innate conscience that God has put inside of you. And I'll tell you to go and consider that. And really look at your heart, and I don't give you an alternative. I say come to Jesus Christ. Because what did he teach? What did he teach? Let me show you what Jesus said. And we got hecklers. Islamic Dawah heckler. Oh, now he's running away. Film the heckler running away. Yes? Okay, let me tell you what Jesus taught. Really quickly before you go, because this is very important.
I was asking you something. Would you please?
Just a minute. We'll talk to you in a second. Okay, let's see what the teaching of Jesus is. I want to give you a better role model. Okay. So this is what Jesus taught. Then some children were brought to him. This is to Jesus, so that he might lay his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, let the children alone and do not hinder them to come to me. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. In other words, God was putting children, young innocent children, a high standard. He said, do not stop them from coming to me. He saw value and worth in them. He didn't just have sex with them, and he did not advise other people. So let me read you another verse from what Jesus said in the book of Matthew again. Let's see what Jesus said. Matthew 18, 1, verse 6. And that time the disciples came to Jesus and said, who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And he called a child to himself and set him before them and said, truly I say to you, unless you are converted and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever then humbles himself as this child, he is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Now listen to this very carefully. And whoever receives one such child in my name receives me. But whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to stumble, okay, like Muhammad did, to indulge in illicit sex or illegal sex, it would be better for him to have a heavy millstone hung around his neck and to be drowned in the depth of the sea. Here, Jesus Christ is making a teaching. We look at the Muhammad and what Muhammad did with Aisha, while she was, you know, a six-year-old child. He was fondling her. When she was 9 years old, he married her. But Jesus said, if you make one of these children to stumble, he says it's better that you have a millstone hung around your neck, drowned at the bottom of the sea. This is how precious and valuable these children are to Jesus. I would encourage you to follow a better role model.
What I'm saying,
which is Jesus
what
Christ.
I'm saying, I encourage you, whenever you quote a verse or hadith, try to understand what has been talked about. Because you're confusing about this chapter, this verse number, ayah number 4. Actually, there's nothing about marriage here. In this verse, it's only talking about problems in periods, how women will have problem period. Example, some women will have a period, they are old, and then sometimes they will see blood, they are not sure. They're talking about those people, those young girls who have not started period. So in case if you have doubt it's their period or not, because as Muslims, if they are bleeding, they are not, example, allowed to pray. They are not allowed to fast.
You
can skip that period. You understand? So this is just talking about period. It has nothing to do with marriage. Marry young girl or old woman. Just talking about the ruling of for those girls to be clean and they are allowed to return back to prayer or no more worship, or those old women, is the same 3 months.
Okay, can
that's the only.
Thank you very much for talking. I'm just going to summarize my camera. Now, I appreciate my talk with Omar. What he was saying is that that surah 65 has nothing to do with marriage. Let me just quickly read you the first verse of that surah, the context. O Prophet, when you divorce your women, you're speaking about divorced women, or divorce them for their prescribed time. It's speaking about marriage and it's speaking about divorcing women. You cannot divorce a woman who's not married. And then it goes on to speak about, you know, prescribed time, you know, before you come in with a woman when she's on her period. Now, the reason I've offered Omar a better example, which is Jesus Christ, because according to his Quran, Surah 19:19, we have Allah saying Jesus was this righteous one, this, you know, one without sin. We have in the Bible where Jesus was sinless. But we have in the Quran also that Muhammad, in Surah 47:19, that he was very sinful. Okay? So the question you have to ask yourself is, who do you follow? Who's the better standard? Who should we follow in terms of our walk or our way in life? The Muslims say Muhammad, but I'd confess to you that Muhammad, no, is nothing that we can follow, because his morals and his standards fall even below Omar's standards. I would encourage them to come to Jesus Christ. He's a perfect role model and he's the greatest example. And today, I would encourage every Muslim, every Christian to choose Jesus Christ. God bless.